everyone. We thought we would show you today how to make a Swan Lake headband. So the first thing you need is a white headband. Now, if you have a headband at home, you can use some white ribbon to cover that very easily. So I'm not going to do this properly, but I'll just show you what you would do. You'd glue the end onto the inside of the bottom of one of the pieces of the headband, and then you would start wrapping on a diagonal, round and round, right around that end you've tucked up as well. And you pop a little bit of glue along the top of the headband as you're going, or the inside of the headband. And this is actually a really easy way to make a nice satin covered headband. We do this for a lot of our props at Little Lines. So you can keep going all the way around until you finish the entire headband and tuck the end under. And you can see it actually is a very simple way to cover a headband. However, I only had this little bit of white ribbon at home and it wasn't quite long enough. So when I went to Spotlight to buy some more ribbon, I found that they actually had this millinery headband that's already done for you. And it was cheaper to buy the headband than it was to buy more ribbon. So we have this headband that's just covered in grosgrain ribbon already done for us. So we'll pop that aside. And then the next thing you need are white feathers. And so we at Spotlight again bought a bag of white feathers, and inside the bag there's all different size feathers. So we've pulled some out of the bag and we've popped all the big ones to the side because I think they're going to be too long and too stiff for our headpiece, and we've just pulled out some medium size and some little short fluffy ones like this that I think will be a little bit easier to work with. Now the next thing you need is craft glue. So we've got our hot glue gun, but any kind of glue, craft glue would be absolutely fine. Now, to be perfectly honest, we have never made a swan headband before. So, what could go wrong? We have feathers, craft glue, and children. Wish me luck. Anyway, I have an idea in my head of how it should work, and hopefully it will come out that way. So the first thing to do is we're going to make a template for the piece that sits on top of the headband that we're going to secure the feathers to. So it's a basic leaf shape. So grab some copy paper, fold it. This is one I made already, but I'll show you how I did it. So we just fold it over. Then we're going to mark 13 centimeters along that folded edge. So that's 13 centimeters and 4 centimeters out from the middle. So you can see here, I've just marked one mark here, and one here. And then I'm going to join those into a leaf shape. So I'll just draw roughly from one point to the other. Doesn't have to be neat. Okay. And then we cut, follow the line with our scissors and cut that out. Okay, there we go. Now you won't actually see this because it'll be covered in feathers. So it doesn't matter if the shape's not perfect, as long as it's roughly a leaf shape. I'm also drawing it back like that. Now you need a little bit of cardboard. We're using white cardboard because then you won't, when we glue the feathers on it, if there are any gaps, you won't see them. So I'll place a piece of paper, my little template, over the top of my cardboard, and I'm going to trace it into a leaf shape. Onto the headband, but I think we're going to glue it onto the headband first and stick the feathers on after. I'm not sure that there's a right or a wrong way, but we'll just give this a go. So one of the points of your leaf will go to the center of the headband, and then we'll wrap it around like that and glue it on. So I'm going to, probably the easiest way to do that is put the glue directly on the headband. I'm going to start at the center and pop the glue across the top, down, and hopefully I'll have gone down the right amount. Then I'll put my cardboard on and wrap it around. Oh, I think it was right. And then just squeeze that on till the glue dries so that it doesn't pop off. I like to that to be nice and firm. Right, the next part is sticking our feathers on. Now, I have put a damp cloth and a tea towel here, just in case it gets messy. I have a feeling we could end up with feathers stuck everywhere. But we'll give it a go. So the first feathers we're going to use are the kind of medium length feathers that we pulled out of the bag, like these little ones. And they're about 10, 11 centimeters long. So we'll start with some of these. Thank you. I'll just lay them all out so I can see them. Here we go, just lay them all out, that's it. And I'll show you, some of the feathers are a little bit curved like that. And I actually think we would like the shape of the feathers to curve down. So if you've got one curved that way, I would place it so that it curves inwards rather than curving out like that.
Look at these.
So we might start with a fairly straight one for the middle. Maybe I'll use that one. The middle. Okay. Can you hold the feather for me? My hair out of my eyes. I'll pop some glue down the middle. And then we'll take this feather. And so the top of the pointy bit of this feather is sort of coming up to the middle of the piece of the cardboard. And then we're just gluing that down. There we go. And then the next one, we'll take a curved one. Maybe that nice, it might be a bit big actually, this one.
Yeah.
We'll take a curved one and we're going to place it next to it, still coming up to the middle of the cardboard. So we're working from the bottom so that they're hanging off the bottom and from the middle of the cardboard. I'll put some more glue in there. Okay. We are continuing the glue the whole way down to the edge of the paper so it pulls the feathers down rather than letting them stick out. So I've got three, you'll be able to see here, one going down and one coming out to the side. Now we're going to continue adding more that way. And then some starting here and coming over these ones. And we'll just keep layering until we get up to the top here. When we get to the top, we're going to use the really teeny tiny little feathers, the little fluffy short ones like this.
This one?
Yeah. Okay, so we'll keep going. What one next? Maybe that one? Like the veins on a leaf. So there's one going down and then one out to the side coming down like this, and we'll keep going like that, and then we might put some on. Alright, we'll stick that on there. And as you're getting closer to the top, start using the smaller feathers so they're not so long. Another smaller one like that one you just gave me. Now I need some shorter ones.
But this one could be
it. So now we're at the top. We've got a little bit of cardboard left up here. We're going to start covering up here with the short ones.
It could be the center at the top.
Like that's a nice one to be right in the middle, isn't it? Okay. And the other thing we're going to do after we finish this, sticking all the feathers on, we're going to pop some jewels on there as well. So you want to make sure, I think that one might actually, even though we thought that, nice up there. You want to make sure you can stick some, you've got room to stick some jewels in.
Mm-hmm.
Let's have a hop. So we'll pop a little bit of glue. This time, the last feather we're popping on, we're going to put a little bit of glue up on the headband here because we'll put the edge of it there. So we've got a little bit of glue up there. Going down. I might need a little bit more there. It's looking good. What do you think?
You're putting another feather on.
Oopsie. Put another feather on. Right down the middle at the top. Make sure it's in the glue. It's nice and firm. Now, we've got all our feathers. Our cardboard here is covered in the feathers. We've got the cardboard underneath. You can see the feathers hanging out over the top, like that. I'm just going to try it on Lulu's head, so we can see. Let me have a look. Oh, it looks beautiful. I was going to say that you can trim off some of these feathers to sort of tidy up the shape. So you could get your scissors out and trim these down this way to make it more of the leaf shape. But I actually really like the fluffy feather ends coming out. So I think we're going to leave it like that. Mm-hmm. I think it looks beautiful.
Can I try?
Of course you can. Hey, let's try. Wow. That looks gorgeous. Stacey, we'll look in the mirror later, okay? Can I lift it off and we'll pop some jewels on?
Can I put some?
We have some craft diamantes and pearls that we have left over from, I think it was one of the girls' birthday parties. So we've got these diamante jewels here and some little pearl ones. And they are sticky. I think they're meant to be stuck on paper though, so I'm not sure how well they'll go on the feathers. So we may need to actually put some craft glue on the backs of these to get them to stick on. We can try. Let me just have a little try and see. Not really. I'm going to pop a little bit of glue on the backs of the diamantes to get them to stay on. Make sure they stay on.
Can we do this one?
And basically I would just start at the top. At the top. And scatter them around just in this top part here. So make... Big diamond shape, do you? Do you like the diamond shape?
Yeah.
You do? Okay. Well, we all have to like it, don't we?
Yeah. What about it's going to be out?
That was a lesson I have learnt through having kids, to relinquish creative control. So we've finished decorating our Swan Lake headband. And as you can see, we've got all our pearls and diamantes coming down and then just scattering down the bottom. And I did end up trimming, I just trimmed this little bit of feather that was hanging off here just to make it curve in nicely on the bottom. So we're going to pop it on Lulu and see what it looks like. Let's see. Now can you turn so they can see this way? Beautiful. All right. Oh, and Sylvie's experimenting with nose piercing. All right. Thanks for watching and we'll see you next time. Bye.